a subtle difference from some of the video presentations I've done before. We aren't using the crocodile link to link our line to our earth bar where our CPC is connected. We've actually physically put the line conductor into the earth bar where the CPC is connected in order that makes a solid link. We're finding that our links at college are becoming a bit unpredictable on our resistance reading. So we'll link those in the consumer unit, slightly different than before. And we go to each point in circuit in order to measure the continuity of CPC. We're also going to include the polarity test at the same time. So we're going to operate the switches. Unlike some of my other video presentations, we're not an all insulated system. So here I've got a metal back box and a metal switch, and those are exposed conductive parts, and I need to prove they're connected to the CPC, not necessarily the earth terminal at the back where the CPCs are connected. I want to know the metal box and the metal frames are connected to the CPC, and that's really important to me in this part of the test. So we've set up our meter, so we've exactly the same, it's just a slightly different ohm meter, and I thought I'd use this one. Orange scale as before is the ohms and the red scale is the mega ohms. I've linked together my leads. I've removed the resistance of the leads by pressing the test button and we're ready to perform the test. So first of all, we're going to go up here to our batten lamp holder. We've got to go in with our probes. It's going to be a little bit tricky. I might need some help with the switches. I'm going to connect onto my line conductor and my CPC. It doesn't matter which way around the leads go, but just so I don't get any comments below, let's put the red one on the brown. Okay, so lead goes on there and then onto my CPCs, and I look at the instrument itself and nothing has happened. Joe, do you want to operate switch number one for me? We can now see we have a reading of 0.03. Operate number switch number two for me, please. And now our circuit has gone off. Operate switch number one again for me, please. So 0.04, operate switch two again for us, please. Okay, so we can turn it on from any point, so just grab a switch and turn it on for us, Joe. Indecision there, didn't matter which one you chose, and you're indecision. So we've got our highest reading that we saw on there was 0.04. We've proved, therefore, the CPC gets up to here, it's a fully insulated system, but we've also proved that the line conductor is switched by the two-way switches, and we went between the switches in the switching sequence. We didn't operate one switch and then operate the others, we switched between them. It doesn't matter whether we leave them on or off, we've left them on at the moment, and we're going to drop down now to the first two-way switch. So I'm going to probe into the back of the light switch itself, I'm going to go into the common terminal, and I'm going to go onto the CPC connection in the back of the box, and I've got a reading of 0.01. It's important that I go now to the exposed conductive part, going to the back of the box itself, 0.01, and I'm going to the front chassis as well. So there's some embossed writing here where it's been scored away, it's engraved, not embossed. So we'll go with that, we'll go in there, we'll go on there, and again, back into the common terminal of the switch itself. So we've got onto there and the common terminal, and we've got a reading of 0.01. Super important to me that we proved it to the CPC terminal in the back. Pretty much irrelevant from the point of view that I needed to prove the metal back box and the metal front plate are connected to the CPC. My highest reading at the moment is still 0.04. I repeat the same process over here. I'm going to go into the common terminal and I'm going to go onto the back box and we get a reading of 0.05, which is now my highest reading. The back box itself, 0.05, and then the front metal work as well. If I go into a slightly different position, the front metal work again, and I've got a reading of 0.05, which is the highest reading currently in circuit. Doesn't matter whether I've left these switches on or off, because we can do the insulation resistance test as required by AM2 and AM2S in the next stage. Remember the highest reading? We checked it at the light fitting and we operated the switches only at the light fitting. We need to know that comes on and off. And we then proved that the exposed conductive part of the metal back box and the metal front plate were connected to the CPC. We also did prove it onto the actual terminal in the back. But for me, that's almost irrelevant if the metal work isn't connected to the CPC.